Sometimes I look up at the night sky and just watch the stars. I try to feel how small we actually are among billions and billions of stars that are in our galaxy, and the billions of galaxies that are out there in the universe. When you focus and try to really think of this unimaginable size, we can get that weird feeling of nothingness and the insight into how small we actually are. Yet our planet itself has something interesting, a power that can't truly be seen, but felt and noticed on the outcomes of its strength, and that is the incredible force of gravity. In our universe, every mass has its own gravity, the force of attraction. I have it, my brother has it, and you have it as well. Even my dog has it. And to be honest, it is just as strong as the Earth's gravity. There just isn't as much of it. This is because of the dramatic difference between the mass of the human body and the Earth, which has the mass of almost approximately 6 septillion kilograms. This number is incredibly big. It is a 6 with over 24 zeros in it, by the way. Our sun has an even more enormous mass, which is 300,000 times bigger, and therefore is a great gravitational force. This holds our entire solar system together, and keeps a tight grip on our blue marble in space called Earth. We have gotten used to this force since the beginning of mankind. But what is it really? Well, let's get down to it. To understand it, we need to make a couple of rules straight. You and the Earth are two masses, both attracting each other, both having a gravitational field. The further you are from Earth, the further you are from its gravitational field, meaning that its gravitational force will be weaker the more distant you are from the center of its mass, and vice versa. Of course, as you start to venture into the planet, more mass will begin to appear over your head, meaning that the mass under you will be less. You would also start to be attracted by the Earth's mass above you, and start to feel lighter than on the surface of the planet. If you're curious, and if you ever made it alive to the exact center of the Earth, you would actually be weightless, as you would be pulled equally in all directions. Here is a theoretical gravity graph of a planet that displays the change of gravity with distance. This is assuming that the planet has an equally spaced density and no other gravitational forces come into the play. We can clearly see that the further you are from the surface of the Earth, the gravitational force becomes weaker. And in theory, this force never exactly disappears, as it infinitely gets smaller and smaller as it tends to zero. So even right now, you're actually slightly pulled by Pluto, which of course does not have any clear nor visible impact here. This makes some good sense. Two masses, each with their own gravity, create a different magnitude of force depending on how distant they are from each other. And this, ladies and gentlemen, is Newton's law of universal gravitation. The things we just discussed can be organized into a nice formula to find out the force between two objects. F gives us the force between the objects in newtons. The little m stands for the smaller mass, and the capital M stands for the larger mass in relation to the other one. We then divide by the square of the distance between the centers of those two masses. Then, we almost have it. We just need to multiply by g, which stands for the gravitational constant. But don't worry, g is nothing to fear of. It is just a constant number that has been found by another British scientist called Henry Cavendish. This gravitational constant, which is believed to be equal throughout the universe, is required to find the force between our two objects. You might also find this formula using different symbols. As long as you remember the structure of this formula, then you will still be able to understand it in whatever way it is presented. Going into formulas, here's another one. It can be used to find the strength of the gravitational field of a single object, such as the Earth's or the Moon's. Remember, don't mix up the small g with the capital G, which stands for the gravitational constant. Alright? We pretty much follow the same rule here for this formula. We multiply the gravitational constant by the mass of the object we want to find the strength of the gravitational field of, and then divide it by the distance from the center of its mass. We can then use this to then find your weight, the force at which you are being pulled down. All you have to do is to just multiply your mass in kilograms by g, which is in the unit of m over s squared. Then you will find your answer in newtons. And that's it. We can now see how gravity works, and how we can use formulas to help us find the force of attraction between two objects, the strength of the gravitational field, as well as the weight of an object. But before we go off, let's look at something interesting in these equations. The formulas use mass to find the answers we needed. But wait a second. What is mass exactly? Well, the scientific definition of mass is how much matter there is in an object. In the international system of units, we use the unit of kilograms for measuring mass. And for the measure of weight force, we use newtons. People sometimes confuse their mass and weight and started to mistakenly use kilograms for both measures. Mass does not change in relation to gravity. The amount of matter there is inside stays the same. As for newtons, the weight force will differ depending on the strength of gravity. On Earth, the strength of the gravity is assumed to be approximately 9.81 meters per second squared on the surface area. But in everyday life, our gravity is often rounded up to just simply 10 meters per second squared. Using one of our formulas, to simply find the weight of an object, we multiply its mass by the gravity strength. Our bathroom scales do the opposite. They measure the force at which we press the scale, but then convert the answer that it displays into kilograms, which makes the number 10 times smaller and making us feel much lighter. People assume and call this number that is in the unit of kilograms as their weight, as mass can be associated with massive. And people don't want to be massive. But then people who aren't aware of this begin to automatically think that our weight is actually in kilograms, which is a mistake. Bathroom scales that are said to measure your weight actually show your mass in kilograms, not weight. This little confusion isn't a problem as long as you can distinguish the numbers by the units and know which one is which. However, when looking at other planets with different gravity values, the scale of the problem grows when using our bathroom scales. If we were to conduct a theoretical experiment, we can see that this can get a little bit confusing. If I was to send my lovely dog to the moon, assuming she would handle all the lack of pressure and air as well as extreme temperatures, we can make hypotheses that her weight would change, but her mass will not. On Earth, after placing her on a bathroom scale, the force at which she was pulled down was 300 newtons, which is her weight. And the scale, using the simple conversion system it has of 10 meters per second squared, displayed 30 kilograms. After taking off and making the journey towards the moon in her cozy spacecraft, we will find that the bathroom scale will give us some different answers. The moon's gravity is now 1/6 of the Earth's, equaling to 1.62 meters per second squared on the surface. As soon as she landed, she quickly rushed to the bathroom and then stood on the scale that she brought from her home on Earth and found a peculiar number on the display. The force of her weight changed and now equaled to 48.6 newtons, which is right. The scale, using the same conversion rate from Earth, divided this force by 10 and gave its answers in kilograms.
Da, da, da!
It is incorrect, since the weight force should have been divided by the moon's gravity, which would still give us 30 kilograms. Now, her mass was 4.86 kilograms. What? Well, thinking that her mass has changed, my dear dog is now in confusion on why that is. Hopefully, after she returns back to Earth, she'll understand what happened after watching this video. Nowadays, because us, the people of Earth, are mistakenly using the unit for mass as their weight, we need to remember and understand the core of this confusion, especially if we were to ever live on other planets or moons with significantly different gravitational forces, so that we never find that the price tag for a kilogram of apples on the moon shows up to be incredibly expensive on Jupiter due to gravity. So, trying to understand this phenomenon of gravity, what would be if it actually wasn't there? Well, gravity is crucial for us to live, and if the physics would ever disobey its own laws, we would quite ironically be in some heavy trouble. As I sit and watch the sky, I am being held by Earth's gravity, same as the moon is held by it, the atmosphere, the oceans, and you are being held by its gravity too.